Let's catch up with the business. Aaron is with us now. Aaron.
Yeah, thanks very much, Lucy. Big day in Europe. Let me explain. Hello there. Do you know what companies do with all that personal data you give them? Yeah. And more specifically, do you know where they send it? Well, Facebook is just one company that transfers it to the United States. But a case that is underway right now in Europe's top court, it's the European Court of Justice, could stop them and hundreds of thousands of other companies moving our data around the world. Here are some of the details. The court is hearing arguments by Austrian privacy activist Max Schrems that a US government, or the US government, doesn't sufficiently protect Europeans' data when it is shipped across the Atlantic. The case comes 4 years after Mr. Schrems brought down Safe Harbor. That's a previous data sharing deal worth billions of dollars between Europe and the United States. And that's at stake now is the legality of so-called standard contractual clauses. That's a complex mechanisms which allow Facebook's and the thousands of other companies to move data freely from Europe to the US and elsewhere. Well, the European Commission considers the system legal. Mr. Schrems and his legal team are arguing that it runs against EU privacy rules because it allows US national security agencies extensive access to Europeans' digital information. Now, the court's decision could potentially pull the plug on cross-border data transfers worth billions of dollars by international companies ranging everything from banks to car makers. I will add the final ruling isn't expected until next year. Let's get more. Dean Armstrong is a leading cybersecurity lawyer at 36 Commercial and joins us. Dean, good to see you. This is about different principles, isn't it?
Yes.
Europe has one principle about our data and the Americans have another.
Absolutely. In a nutshell, the difference is that in Europe, the GDPR brought in...
That's the
General Data Protection Regulation.
Yeah.
Came in May last year.
Mm.
And what it brought in was effectively that personal data is your property,
right?
Much like your car, mm-hmm. much like anything that you would call your own. So your ability to control that, where it goes, what happens to it, is at the centerpiece of that regulation. So Europe has come along and said, right, you're in charge of it. What you do with it is up to you. If anybody else holds it, you hold it as a custodian as opposed to a person with ability to deal with it as you think fit.
Mm.
The American principle is different in the sense that data is very much for sale in the States.
Yeah, it's a business.
It's a very, very large business, one of the biggest businesses actually in the United States. And so what we have here in regards to this case that's going on at the moment is almost a clash of principles. So on one side of the Atlantic, the fact that it's your data, your personal asset, contribution, etc., as opposed to the Americans would say, well, actually, it belongs to us, and therefore we can do what we will with it.
And we're running pictures right now. This is from earlier on in the court. But As a layman, I'm talking about me here, a bit of a dummy when it comes to it, you look out around the world and it feels like there's all sort of patchwork systems going on, because if you look at Asia, parts of Asia, Russia, India, they're looking at keeping the data, right? Is it localized data?
Yes, in certainly the Data Protection Act in respect of Russia and China, their data is kept and it's an obligation. You keep the data domestically, so on domestic servers.
So it could get transferred from Europe, let's say, to India.
Yes.
And India then keeps it.
The government has an element of control because it's kept on a data localization platform. Now, that means, therefore, that the government are effectively in control of it.
Wow. Okay.
And again, that runs counter to the European principle of it's your data, you do what you wish with it. Now, I should add that India is going through a consultation process. It's at the moment looking to follow the Russian and Chinese examples of data localization, but it's not yet decided formally to do so. So your point is well made in the sense that what you have at the moment, if you're a business seeking to run in different jurisdictions, then you may have as many as three or four different principles that you have
to... You're having to deal with it. Can I just quickly get this in? This court ruling, the one that when we eventually get it, experts in your field have been telling me, look, this will certainly have a global impact. Some even going as far as saying it could actually have an impact on the global economy.
Yes, and I think the important thing to recognise here is that the American companies in particular are seeing the fact that GDPR, the European regulation, because of the amount of data transfer that flows between across the ocean, they are going to have to comply in some way. And therefore, the mood music coming out of the States companies is very much, we understand the need to be much more pragmatic about how we deal with data. a much more of a nod to it's your data as opposed to our data. And so the effect of that will be potentially greater compliance regulation, obviously ways in different ways that people use data in American companies. So there's a lot to be play for in the future in respect of this.
Yeah, okay. I know you'll be keeping across it, as we will, and we'll talk to you again soon. Thanks very much, Dean. A pleasure. Dean Armstrong joining us there. Okay, let me just touch on some of the other stories making